Hey guys, welcome back to our channel Agricare. In this video we are going to discuss about the different types of flower based on the position of floral parts on thalamus with respect to ovary. So let's start this video and discuss about every types of flowers. Based on this, there are three types of classification. The first one is hypogynous, second one is perigynous, third one is epigynous. So these three types we will discuss in this video. Let's start with hypogynous flower. What is a hypogynous flower? In this flower, the thalamus are cup shaped, flask shaped or tubular. Maybe cup shaped or flask shaped, that means it is like a bottle shape, or it is in tubular shape like this. So the points to remember in the hypogynous flower is: the ovary is superior in nature. Superior, from this picture you can see this. The ovary is superior. It is present above in the thalamus. All the other floral parts arise below the level of ovary. So this one is the ovary, and the other floral part, it arise below from the ovary. So I hope you will understand the hypogynous type of flower. The example is citrus and brassica tomato flowers. Next one is perigynous flowers. Perigynous flowers, in this the thalamus are disc shaped, cup shaped and the flask shaped. So in discs, the disc shape, the gynoecium is present in the center, and the other floral parts, these are present at the periphery of the disc. The next one is the cup shape. The gynoecium is present in the bottom of the cup, present at the bottom of the cup, and the other floral balls, these are present on the rim. Rim means the end of the cups, like this one. The flask shape. In the flask shape, what happens is the gynoecium is present at the bottom, and the other floral parts, they are present at the mouth of the flask. The ovary is half superior, and the other floral parts arise around the level of the ovary. From this picture you can see that the floral parts, these are present around the ovary. So the examples are rose, plum and peach flower are example of perigynous flower. Next we will discuss about the epigynous flower. In this, the thalamus is cup shaped, flask shaped and tubular, in which the ovary gynoecium is completely inserted. From this photo of cucurbits you can see that the gynoecium is completely inside the floral appendages. And the main point to remember is the ovary is inferior, and the other floral parts, these arise above the level of the ovary. The best example is ovary, and from this picture you can see how a epigynous flower looks like. So I hope so this video will help you understand the different types of flower based on the thalamus and ovary positions. Subscribe and hit the like button for more updates.